Why are we the way that we are? As we approach the end of 2023, science has pushed research forward closer to answering this question. I'm Rose Basom, the David and Jane Cohn scientists here at the Science Museum of Virginia, and here are my top five biological anthropology news stories of 2023. Number five, tool making. One of the ways humans are considered unique is their ability to make complex stone tools. New research from wild macaque monkeys have challenged how we interpret hominins, aka our ancient human ancestors' earliest tool technologies. Researchers observed that macaques in Thailand use rounded pieces of limestone, called hammer stones, to crack open nuts using a stone platform. But when they miss, a piece of the hammer stone flakes off on accident. Making flakes intentionally is a process known as knapping, which was used to create more complex stone tool technologies as humans evolved. The shape of the flakes accidentally made by the macaques actually look really similar to some of the flakes made by hominins in one of the oldest tool technologies called Oldowan. Scientists actually estimate that around 20 to 30% of Oldowan flakes produced may not have been made intentionally like we originally thought. But this information helps scientists better interpret hominin tool use and the story of becoming human. Number four, hey grandma. Menopause, a process that ends the ability to reproduce, is extremely rare in the animal kingdom, only previously seen in some whales and humans, or so we thought. But why are they the only mammals in the wild to experience menopause? One popular explanation is the grandmother hypothesis, where older females ensure that their genes are passed on to future generations by helping take care of their grandbabies. But this doesn't quite work in wild chimpanzees. While researchers discovered they also go through menopause and live for many years after, they're actually not involved in raising offspring related to them, which throws a wrench into the hypothesis. Some scientists now think that menopause may occur to prevent reproductive competition with younger females that they're related to. While we haven't cracked the case, researchers are steps closer to solving that mystery. Number three, family teeth. Mitochondria might be the powerhouse of the cell, but DNA is the cookbook for protein. DNA degrades really quickly as remains of organisms are replaced with minerals during fossilization, so it's pretty rare to find. However, proteins, which are created using DNA, last a lot longer in fossils. Scientists extracted proteins from the tooth enamel of hominins called Paranthropus robustus that lived around 2.2 million years ago. Studying these proteins and comparing them to genetic data from other hominins allowed researchers to help support our current understanding of the hominin family tree. However, the most exciting discovery was being able to estimate sex using chromosomes. Some enamel proteins are made using information from Y chromosomes. This means that those individuals were likely males. While this research still needs the stamp of approval from other scientists in a process called peer review, this could be another avenue for helping find new species, find their place within the family tree, and help shed light on variation within species. Number two, counting your chickens. Speaking of peer review, let's talk about Homo naledi, one of the latest hominin species to be discovered. This year, a preview of three papers were made public before going through peer review. In the papers, researchers claim that Homo naledi, who lived around 330,000 years ago, used fire, intentionally buried their deceased, and created art. If this is true, this would push the date of the earliest intentional burials in art back by over 100,000 years, which is a really big deal. Peer review is really important in evaluating how valid and strong scientific research papers are. However, during review, fellow scientists found that the evidence presented in the papers were not strong enough to support these claims. This work went viral before the papers were reviewed, highlighting the importance of the peer review process. And number one, nature versus nurture. Why do we find ourselves reaching for tasty foods high in fat and sugar, even though we're not hungry? Nature versus nurture is a classic question that science aims to demystify. The part of the brain that's associated with reward and motivation in primates is called the nucleus accumbens. A chemical in the brain called neuropeptide Y is found in high amounts in this area, which increases the desire to find high sugar and high fat foods, specifically when not hungry. A study of 13 different primate species found that humans have higher concentrations of this neurochemical in the nucleus accumbens compared to others. Neuropeptide Y may have been helpful for our ancestors to be more successful in reproducing and help develop larger brains, which requires a lot of calories. But in today's society, where we generally have better access to food, this can lead to ingesting a lot of extra calories that our body doesn't need to immediately use. So, the next time you find yourself looking for something to eat, even though you're not hungry, know that Neuropeptide Y is encouraging you. Well, that's a wrap on 2023, but I can't wait to see what biological anthropology has to bring in 2024.